Hey, hello and welcome all my dear students of third standard. Girls and boys, welcome to the science lecture once again. This is Rohan sir from Mahdi English Medium School. I welcome you all back once again in the revision lecture of chapter 11, Light, Sound and Force part 2. Students, in the previous lecture, that means in the part 1 lecture, we just revised the concepts of this chapter of light, sound and force and the sub concepts which were the part of the main concept. We just had the reading part and the explanation part to make a short recall. Then all my dear students, now we have to start with the objective solution. Because in the previous lecture, after having a good recall onto the topics, we also had a good recall for the keywords. I hope that you have written those revision keywords. Now, today what is our plan is, we will solve the objectives on the basis of previous revision lecture. But first of all, I need to ask you, have you watched the previous revision lecture or not? Because yes, like I said, that all the lectures in the sequence are interconnected, are interlinked. If you do not watch the previous lecture, you will not be able to enjoy, nor will you be able to connect yourselves with the present lecture. So please make sure, don't break this sequence, watch the lectures in the sequence. Now, as you are watching this lecture, we will solve the objective of chapter 11. I suppose you should be having your rough book now. Now, it's been very common thing in the science lecture that you always have to carry a rough book with you, whether it is a video lecture or a live lecture. My dear little champs, please give the heading Chapter 11, Light, Sound, Force, Textual Objectives. That is what we are going to do here in this lecture. And now this might be the third or fourth time we are revising it in the different ways. Now, I suppose at least now you don't need the help of anyone. So, sit only and only with your rough book and pencil. Anyways, I hope that you might have started giving the heading. Also, please do mention today's date. Now, display the textbook on the screen. Yes, I know you might be able to see the textbook on the screen, and yes, this is not the front page. This is what we have done in the previous lecture, keywords. Correct? I asked you to write the keywords in the previous lecture when I was reading it and explaining it to you. So let's just read out the summary and start solving the objectives. Summary points. The sun is the main source of heat and light on Earth. There are various sources of lights on the planet Earth, but the sun is natural and main source of light and heat as well. Light helps us to see things. This is also what I explained it to you in the previous lecture, that when you enter into the dark room at night, you need to switch on the lights, otherwise you will not be able to see the things clearly. So light helps us to see the things. Shadow are formed when the objects block the path of the light. This is what you know, that when you stand in front of the light, facing towards the light, your shadow will be on your backside because you are stopping the light rays from falling on the floor. We hear sound with the help of our ears. Yeah, this even the kids might be knowing. Sound can be soft or loud, pleasant or unpleasant. So sound can be of any type. Very loud, very soft. You know, sometimes in the classroom when you were sitting, when some of the students, they get up and speak or they ask the doubt, we cannot hear what they are speaking because they have very soft tone or they have very low tone. So here the sound changes, soft and loud, pleasant and unpleasant. Force helps us to move objects, stop them and change their shape. This is what force can do. It can stop an object. It can just move the object from one place to another place, or it can even change their shapes. Friction slows down the movement of objects. Because of friction, the movement becomes slower. So I hope these summary points are clear enough now for you to solve the objectives. Please give the heading textual exercise, question 1, question A, F, B. Question 1, question A, F, B. So main question and sub questions are divided here. Write accordingly, please. I will wait for the couple of seconds for you to give the heading properly. Okay, girls and boys, I hope you all are ready now. Here you have to write the question. I mean to say just the question and the answer, not the options given in the brackets. I hope I'm making everything very, very clear. You have to write the questions, but don't write the options. Directly write the answer. This is what I mean to say. So I hope that you have given the heading. Now I'll be reading question one by one. You will have to write the question and the answer as well at the same time. Let's get started. The sun is a dashed source of light. Options, as you can see, man-made or natural. Which source of light is the sun? Is it made by man or is it by the nature? Your time starts now. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. See, boys and girls, please try to write the answer questions properly along with the answer. As in all the lectures, we have different formats. In this lecture, you have to write the question along with the answer. That's the format. Anyways, I'll give the answer of all five together. A shadow is dashed at noon. Long or short? So how is the shadow during the noon time? Is it long or short? I hope that you have started writing the question at least. A shadow is dashed at noon, long or short? The picture was given related to the shadow, remember? Was very easy. Try to find out the answer. Your time starts now. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. Okay, next. Our ears helps us dash sound. Make or hear? What is the duty of our ears making the sound of hearing it? Try to find out the answer. It's very easy, I know. You don't need much of the time, but still. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. Okay. Next, Dash sound is called noise. Loud or unpleasant sound or soft and pleasant sound, which sound is called noise? Pair of words are given on each side of or. Your time starts now. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. Okay. A push or pull is called dash. Friction or force. What is push or pull called? It's very easy if you have understood the chapter. Anyways, your time starts now. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. Okay, I suppose you should have written the answer for all the questions. Please check your answers now. The sun is a dash source of light. Is it made by anyone? Look at the sun. Is that made by any scientist or anyone else? No. So it is not a man-made. It is a natural. Natural is the answer. I hope that you have written the same answer. Number 2. A shadow is dashed at noon. Is shadow long or short at noon? So shadow is short at noon, long in the morning. So short is the answer anyways. I hope that you have written the same answer. If you have written the same answer as I am typing here, you can put a tick mark like this so that you will come to know how much are wrong and how much are right answers. Okay. Next. Our ears helps us dash sound, hear the sound. Here is the answer. H-E-A-R. Okay. Dash sound is called noise. Dash sound is called noise. Loud and unpleasant or soft and pleasant sound, which is called noise? Do you create a noise at home? Yes. So what is noise? It is loud and unpleasant sound, which one does not like to hear to for the long time, right? Number 5. A push or a pull is called force. Even in the previous lecture, I showed you the live example of force using the school drawer and school here door. So here you know that how the drawers are push or pulled. When you want to open the drawer, it is pull. When you want to close it, it is called push. So this is what I have explained you in the previous lecture as well. Now let's move towards the next section, true or false. Leave one or two lines and then give the heading question B, true or false. Just write true or false. I hope, students, you are getting sufficient enough time to give the heading, write the questions and write the answer. As you don't have to write the option, I suppose fill in the blanks was okay for you as far as the time is concerned. Okay, here also, students, in true or false, you have to write the question and then the answer. So please try to increase your speed. This is what I am forcing you to write because you should practice writing daily. Okay, I hope that you have given the heading true or false. There are 5 questions. Again, the same thing we will implement. After solving all the 5, I will give you the answer for all these 5. And I hope that will be okay for you all. Let's get started. Number 1. Friction is a type of force. I hope that you have started writing the question. Friction is a type of force. Is it so? Think about it after writing the question. Write the answer. Your time starts now. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. Okay, I suppose you should have written the answer. Number 2, please start writing the question. I'm reading it. All objects give off light. All objects give off the light. Is this true or false? Think about it. Your time starts now. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. So I hope that you have written the answer. Number 3. All sounds are pleasant. All sounds are pleasant. So try to think. Your time starts now. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. Moving towards the next one, number 4. Shadows of different objects are of different colors. Shadows of different objects are of different color. Again, this is very easy to think. Previous lecture, I have explained it to you very well regarding the shadows and its colors. So think about it. I hope that you have finished writing the question. Your time starts now. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. Next one is, friction makes things go faster. Is this true? So try to think. I hope that you have written the question or you might be writing the question. Friction makes the thing go faster. Your time starts now. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. Okay, now it's the time for you to check your answer. Friction is a type of force. Yes, it is a type of a force, which is written in your textbook also. So this statement is true. Number 2, all objects give off the light. Is it so? All the objects give off the light. Your bag, your water bottle, everything, your mobile phone, your tube light at home, everything gives out the light? No. So it is incorrect statement. False. All sounds are pleasant. Do we like to listen to all the types of sounds? Not necessarily. Sometimes we get irritated by few other sounds. So all sounds are pleasant. False. Like all objects are not luminous, all the sounds are not pleasant. Next, shadow of different objects are different color. No, whether you are wearing blue, red, black, white, whatever clothes you are wearing, your shadow will be black. So shadows of different objects are of different colors. False. Next, friction makes things go faster. Because of friction, the things go faster? No, in fact, the things stop down, right? So this statement is also a false statement. I hope that you get the answer and you were checking your answers. Now is the time to solve. Choose the correct option. Please give the heading question C. Choose the correct options. Please give the heading properly. Now here, what do we have to do? You don't have to write the question or the option, just the answer two times. Okay, so let's get started. I hope that you have given the heading MCQ. Okay. Which of these is not source of light? So, sun, glowworm, bulb or bottle? So, which of these is not a source of light? Which of these objects does not give out the light? Options are sun, glowworm, bulb or bottle. Please try to find out the answer. Your time starts now. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 and 0. Next, which of these is not true about a shadow? It is always black, it is true. Its length is different at different times of the day. It is formed on the opposite side or it is always short. Which of this is not true about shadow? So your time starts now. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Okay, so I hope that you have chosen your answer. Which of these is an unpleasant sound? Means you don't like to listen to. Options are chirping of birds, sounds of waterfall, loud scream of a child or sound of sea waves. Which of these is not unpleasant? Is an unpleasant sound, not pleasant sound. Your time starts now. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 and 0. Okay, next. What are the three things that force can do on an object? So options are push, pull, peel or friction. These are the options. Try to select the correct answer. Your time starts now. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 and 0. Okay, I suppose you should have got the answer for this as well. Number 5. Which of these is a pleasant sound? Pleasant sound means the sound which you like to listen to, which does not distract you or disturbs you. So, bursting of firecrackers, crying of baby, sound of wind chime, or barking of a dog. So, which of this sound is the pleasant sound? Try to find out the answer. Your time starts now. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 and 0. I hope, students, you have written the answer properly with answer number. Now is the time for you to check your answers, whether what you have selected is the correct answer or is incorrect answer. You know that you have to put tick mark and cross mark accordingly. So let's see. Which of these is not a source of light? Sun is the main source of light actually. Glowworm, it is said glowworm. Why? Because it has the light of its own. Bulb, you know, all of you might be having bulb at your places. It gives out the light. But bottle does not give out the light. Correct? Bottle does not give out the light. So bottle, is not the source of light. Which of these is not true about shadow? It is always black. Its length is different times in a day. It is formed on the opposite side of light, or it is always short. It is always short is incorrect statement. That means correct answer. Which of these is an unpleasant sound which you don't like to listen to? So obviously loud scream of a child. I hope you are correcting your answers if at all you have written the incorrect answer. See, it happens that you will get incorrect answers because you might have forgotten the topic. That is the reason why I sent you the revision video lecture, and that is the reason why are we solving this again in the lecture. What are the three things that force can do to an object? Three things: push, pull, friction. These things can be done. Okay, I hope that you read the question properly and you have answered it. Number 5. Which of these is the pleasant sound? So obviously sound of wind chimes, which you hang it on the wall or on the window, and when the wind enters the house, the music is played. That's called wind chim. So with this, students, I end my today's lecture. I hope that you are writing the answers and the questions whenever I asked you to write it. So please make sure you complete your homework. If anything is left, check it. Always have the habit of checking what you have written and then submit it to your follow-up teachers. Goodbye, have a nice day.